Okay, good morning children. As you are preparing for the board exam, we should concentrate on do's and don'ts of the exam. First thing is, which you don't have to use, that is the do not use black pen. CBSE has restricted black pen in your exam. So when you are marking your main points in the exam, many of the children are having the practice to mark the main points. So whenever you are marking the main points, you always have to use pencil. Instead of black pen, you have to use pencil. Second is, do not panic when you are going for the board exam. Because whenever you are going, this time you are attempting for the first time. So whenever you are attempting for the first time, you get panicked that how the paper will come, how we are going to solve, we are having only 3 hours, in this 3 hours we have to write down so much. You don't have to get panicked. The thing is that you have to think that how I am going to solve the paper. So here, this is the thing that you have to pour everything. Boiling water. You have to pour your the whole year, whatever you have learned, that you have to pour out in this boiling water. This boiling water is your paper. So do not panic. Now we are going to, without wasting time, we are going to solve this paper. That you have to go for the time limit. Just concentrate on the time limit and you will be able to solve this paper before half an hour. Before half an hour, so that half an hour you can utilize it for revising your paper, that whether you have not left out any of the questions or whether some points are missing, so you can revise that paper in this half an hour. Now how you are going to decide that how we have to go for the sections, how we have to write the paper? See, the whole paper is divided into three sections, section A, section B and section C. Section A, it is of reading part and it consists of 20 marks. Section B, it is of writing and grammar section, which consists of 30 marks. And section C, it is of literature part and it consists of 30 marks. So in this way, your 80 marks has been segregated. Now, the first thing which you are going to appear for the which section you have to appear, that is section A. This reading section, it all the children, they nearly waste nearly 1.5 hours in this section, right? So you have to reduce this time, because if you are not reducing this time, then you are not able to complete this paper in 3 hours. So how you are going to reduce this time? 15 minutes before you are given the paper, that is for reading the paper. So you don't have to look to section B and section C, because you know that you are going to attempt both this section and you know the answers for this, because you have already prepared the answers for this. But here, this is an unseen passage and you are not prepared for this unseen passage. So what you have to do is, within this 15 minutes, you have to go through the unseen passage. Now, you don't have to go line wise, right? You don't have to go line wise. First thing is that you have to read the questions. Read the questions first, right? Now, you know that what questions are being asked. So, second thing is that you have to now go through this unseen passage. The first unseen passage is, see here, the first unseen passage, it is of MCQs, right? So MCQs, it contains of 1 marks each. 1 mark each. So what you have to do is, you are with this 5 minutes for the first question, because it consists of 1 marks, so only you have to write down what is asked in the question. That is, you don't have to extend your answer more than 2 lines. You don't have to extend your answers more than 2 lines. Why? Because it consists of 1 mark only, and this 1 mark you have to write down only 2 lines where you are going to get 1 mark. Right? So this 15 minutes you are going to utilize in this. Out of 15 you have utilized 5 minutes. Now you are knowing that the answer is here, the answer is here. You have to remember at that time. Don't think of anything while you are going through the paper. Only just concentrate on the paper. Now, 5 to 7 minutes are left for the question 2. Question 2, it consists of 2 marks answer. Right? So, 2 marks answer, you don't have to exceed the answer more than 4 lines. That is, within 3 to 4 lines, you have to complete the answer. Now, how you are going to go for this answer? Because this was 1 mark answer, you can find out the answers. But this is 2 mark answer, right? So, what you have to do is, again, the same strategy you have to go. That is, read the unseen passage. Sorry, read the questions first. Again, so while you are reading the question, you come to know that what you have to write down, what this passage is about, and what is the title of the passage. See, through the title of the passage and question, you can come to know that what this passage is about. So, while you are attempting the question, while you are going through the passage, you will come to know that what will be the answer. So, just go through the passage. Don't read each and every line. Just go through the passage. Then go at once. You have to glance the passage, right? While you are glancing the passage, at that time only you are going to get at least 2 to 3 questions. 2 to 3 questions answer. So here your time limit, this has reduced to half an hour, because here 15 minutes also you have taken. So nearly 45 minutes you have given to both the question. So within 45 minutes you should complete question 1 and question 2. This will be your time limit. Okay, now we are going with section B. Section B consists of 30 marks, and this section B, it is very time consuming, because here you have to think and then write down. Section C, you have already read out the whole year, you know, the summary, you know. So, you will be able to attempt section C very easily. But section B, here you have to think. You have to explore your ideas over here. So, here for that ideas, you need at least 1 hour. So, in this 1 hour only, you have to decide that you have to complete at least this section B. Now, first, you are going for the letter. Letter. You should know the format, that what the format is, and according to the format only you have to write down the letter. So letter, if you are knowing the format, you can write this letter within 10 to 15 minutes. So here 10 to 15 minutes you have to complete question 3. Then you have to attempt question 5, that is your grammar section. Grammar section, this is objective type. So, in this objective type, first you are going to get gap filling. This gap filling, it will be optional. That is, options will be given in this. So, while attempting these options, this you have to complete in 5 minutes. Then comes up your error and omission. Error omission, only 4 points are coming up. So for this 4 points also, you need only 5 minutes. Right? So here 15 plus 5, 20, and plus 5, 25. And the last is rearrangement of sentences. So, rearrangement of sentences, At least within 5 minutes you have to complete this. That is question 3 and question 5. Both you have to complete it in 30 minutes. Now still 30 minutes is left over here. Now this 30 minutes you have to utilize in the story. This is sufficient for the story. Because story you have to write down in 4 paras. And 4 paras you can write down the story within 30 minutes. So here your time limit for 1 hour that you have completed. So 1 hour 45 minutes you have completed till question 5. That is nearly more than 60% of the paper you have attempted. Now remains 30 marks. That is section C, literature part. So in this literature part, the first question which is asked, that is question 6, is of extract. Extract, this is, each question carries 1 mark because it is of 4 mark. So here you have to utilize only 5 to 10 minutes. Because 2 to 3 line answers you have to write down. So here 5 to 10 minutes you are going to utilize in this. Then comes up question 7, that is of 2 marks each. 5 you have to attempt. So 2 into 5, 10 marks. Now while attempting this 5 into 10 marks answer, each answer you have to write down 4 to 5 lines. 4 to 5 lines you are writing. And in this 4 to 5 lines, how much time you are going to utilize? That is, if you are counting half minute for one line, right? So now you have to attempt 5 questions. That is at least 20 minutes you are going to utilize for question 7. Now comes up question 8, question 9. These are essay type question. Now this essay type question you have to attempt. That is 30 minutes plus 20 minutes plus 10 minutes, 30 minutes. And within 30 minutes you are going to attempt this last questions. So now 15 minutes are left. 15 to 30 minutes are left for your for revising the paper. That is, now you have to go through that whether you have left out any of the question, or are you missing any of the main points, or are you have you not marked the main points. So for this you are going to get this 15 to 30 minutes, right? So in this way you are going to complete this paper within 2.5 hours. This paper you are going to complete it within 2.5 hours. So please remember, don't panic when any of the paper comes up to you. Even though if you are not knowing the paper, 5 minutes go for the meditation. Remember what you have learned for the whole year. You have paid attention in the class. Remember the points, which points ma'am has told you or sir has told you, and then go for the paper. Easily you are going to solve this paper. Okay? Okay, this was a short review how you have to solve the paper. This is when you are pouring everything, whatever you have done in the whole year, that you are pouring in the boiling water. So if you are pouring in the boiling water, that means you need time management. So how you have to go for the time management and how you have to solve the paper within 2.5 hours. Your main target should be that you have to complete the paper, and that also perfectly you have to complete the paper in 2.5 hours. Within 2.5 hours you have to complete the paper. This will be your target. Stay tuned with us for our next video, how we have to go for the revision, every last moment revision, how you are going to attempt. Thank you very much.